So Roberto Fernando Savide with the brief final instructions between these two incredibly decorated boxers. What a contest we have in store here.
Round one.
So we're underway then. Two men who will be going to Tokyo 2020, having competed on the Olympic stage before. The man wearing red, Vikas Krishan Yadad, 28 years of age from India, competed in London 2012 and Rio 2016. At Rio 4 years ago, he was up in the 75 kilogram middleweight division. He's back down at 69, where he contested his first Olympic Games in London 8 years ago. The man wearing blue, boxing out of the southpaw stance as well, is Ablai Khan Jusupov, the reigning world championship bronze medalist, his second consecutive bronze on the world championship stage, despite being just 23 years of age. He's the tournament number 2 seed, ranked number 5 in the world. And both of these men, well, they have been good for so long that they have both been world youth champions and both took medals in the Youth Olympic Games. Vikas in the inaugural edition, in Singapore, where he came away with Youth Olympic bronze, and Jusupov at Nanjing 4 years ago, 6 years ago, it's 2020 now, he came away with top spot on the podium, adding to the World Youth Championship he won earlier that year and the World Junior title he took in 2013. So two incredibly talented, skillful boxers who have been squeezing the most from their immense potential, bidding to book their place in the championship final here.
Yeah, you've described that perfectly, Ronald. Both these guys are of the highest caliber of operators in Olympic style boxing. Personally, I prefer Zusupov's style. I like what he does. He's great to watch. He can do a little bit of everything. But of course, Vikas, a world class performer in his own right. This is going to be very, very close bout, I feel.
Exchange of jabs.
Yeah.
Jusupov was flat-footed and so solid, it jolted the head back of the man in red. Good right jab to the body from Jusupov. Nice evasive maneuver with the feet and from the waist from the man in blue. Vikas tucking up tightly to repel the counter of the man from Kazakhstan. Double jab is again evaded by Jusupov. He's then forced to miss with his first shot of that, what was ultimately a three-shot combination. Beautiful right jab landed twice from Vikas. The second one was an up jab from the belt line. Corkscrew jab attempted by Vikas, the final shot of that flurry. Very good round of boxing.
Just technically efficient round from both men. And a sigh from the Indian coaches as they say, okay, how do I go about explaining to my charge here how to take on this man now? Good head movement there from Jusupov, swaying left to right with the hands high, making it exceedingly difficult for Krishan Vikas to get any punches off. But look at that scoring run.
Only judge 3 favouring the work of Jusupov. Judges 1, 2, 4, and 5 favouring the work of Vikas. A very close competitive round, make no mistake. Vikas sent out with stern words from his corner and a forceful slap on his traps to begin this second round. So a sporting touch of gloves between these southpaws gets round 2 underway. Beautiful work from Vikas. He caught the double jab from Jusupov and then countered with a jab of his own. Tucking up tightly once again, grinning his gum shield contemptuously and scores with a southpaw left. It's been a brilliant start from Vikas. Very measured. The man in blue has started more aggressively, but the point scoring punches have come from the man in red.
Whoa, look at that. Pushing him back with a jab all the way to the ropes. But good slipping and sliding there from Vikas as Jusupov advanced.
Again, you see the jab being caught on the gloves and then Vikas scored with a right jab to the body. So plenty of activity from Jusupov, and the up jab in evidence once again from the man in red. The heads nice. Coming together, and then a backhand followed from Vikas. He's boxing brilliantly in the first minute of this second round.
Good defense as well. Nice tight guard there from Vikas. Ronald, he's just like almost got himself into a much quicker rhythm than what he did in the first round. Oh, there is a cut, is there?
Oh, dear.
Yeah.
The heads
what
did
a shame.
Come together. And
oh,
there's a cut.
Man.
Now, no boxer wants to receive a cut, but Vikas, he's blinking furiously. He's been bothered by that, but it isn't in the worst of positions. See that gesture from the referee, the knuckles bumped together beneath the latex gloves.
Yep.
This cut has been caused by an accidental clash of heads, not from a scoring punch. Again, no boxer wants to incur a cut. Just trying to get a look as to where it is. The doctor going through the protocol of checking the vision of Vikas. Well, I thought it was above the forehead, above the eyebrow, but it's actually on the eyebrow. So this is worse than I first anticipated. Vikas giving the all clear to continue after boxing brilliantly for the first minute of this second round. He's unfortunately picked up a cut to the eyebrow and now has that adversity to deal with. He's getting on the front foot now. Jusupov looking to work off the back foot and scoring well to
nice.
The body.
Good punch in there from Zupov there.
Where the blood first appeared on the forehead of Vikas, I thought that's where the cut had been incurred, but it's right beneath the eyebrow. And that, among the worst places as Jusupov lands a peach of a left cross.
Vikas just came up the wrong way there. And as he came up, he basically went right into the right hand of Jusupov.
So since the cut, the man in blue has been boxing very well indeed. But don't forget the blistering first minute of the second round that Vikas produced. Oh, that's a good right jab again from the man in red.
Double
so
up.
Potent. Vikas with a flashing left cross and another beautiful up jab.
That jab's working so well for him, isn't it? And he really steps in behind it, Ronald, when he gets a bit of range. Scores with a right hook to the body there.
Now, after the cut, he scores with a right jab again. After the cut, he went after the man in blue.
Yeah.
And that's when the man in blue had his best portion of the round.
It was. It
when he's at
was.
This type of territory where he can work behind that jab as he digs in a good left hook. While Vikas is having more success when he's boxing in behind that southpaw right. When he took it to the man in blue, that brought Jusupov right into it. Flashing right hook landed from Vikas as the cut begins to leak blood once again. Beautiful right jab
that's
from his waistband.
Jab. Fantastic jab, isn't it?
Well, what a terrific round we had. The first minute, in my opinion, belonged to this man. Then he picked up that cut after the clash of heads and went after Jusupov, bringing the man in blue right back into the contest for the second minute. But then in the third minute, as we see the clash which caused the cut, the clash of heads which caused the cut, but in the third minute,
this man's
he got back
jab.
To distance and his jab was beautiful to watch.
It won him the round for me, Ron. I don't know about you, but it certainly did win him the round for me. Fantastic, sharp, long, accurate jab. And when he stepped with it as well, it really offset Jusupov.
So the scores...
3-2
split. 3-2 in favour of the man in red, which I didn't necessarily agree, but I thought he was pretty much the boss for the majority of that round. Make no mistake, Jusupov had his successes too. But this contest in the balance... And Vikas dealing with the adversity of a cut.
Third and final round.
So again, terrific sportsmanship to begin this third and final round between two incredibly skillful boxers. Both have booked their place to successive Olympic appearances. But what a contest they are having here.
What a body shot there from Jusupov. He landed a heavy left uppercut to the body in the second round as well. Vikas recovering from them really quickly, testimony to his conditioning and his fitness.
When he gets back to this distance and works behind that jab, well, it's been a real nuisance for Jusupov. But up close, oh, that's a nice check right hand from Vikas. Celebrated it as he skipped off to his right. Covering up well on the ropes and sliding out of the way of the punches effectively.
Certainly did, gliding over his shoulders, skiffing past his head.
Beautiful movement on the ropes once again. Terrific composure from Vikas.
Yep, he can read those coming.
Good work to the body from the man in blue, catching the advancing Vikas, who counters with a three-shot combination of his own, body and head. Good right uppercut through the middle from the man in blue.
Nice.
But look at that. Left hook, right uppercut from Vikas out of that southpaw stance. Oh, now what was that? Was that a free right hand?
Yeah, sure was. Jucked it right under the chin of Vikas.
Left hook to the body is a good shot on a resumption from Jusupov. So beyond the midpoint of the final round, but that's terrific defense from Vikas once again, catching those shots on his gloves and then countering with a right-left combination followed by that right jab, which had been so effective for him.
And he has no problem being on the ropes there either with his slippery, evasive movements.
Now, in this posture last time,
yeah,
Zafiulin hit him with a rather forceful-looking right hand.
Yeah, chopping right uppercut to the chin.
So Vikas up on his toes, looking to establish that right jab once again. Right on cue, it's popped out, but not with as much force as he's used previously. Inside the final minute of a keenly contested affair here in the 69-kilogram welterweight semi-final, the winner will progress to face the man from Amman right here in Jordan in tomorrow's final. So, who can produce some sustained quality? Both men trading misses during that coming together. And that's a nasty cut beneath the left eye of Vikas, sustained in the second round.
Yeah, he can't find the target, Zusupov.
But he's busier in the closing seconds.
Yeah, good hard work from the man in blue towards the end there. But it's too little too late for me, Ron, I feel.
I share that point of view, Alex, and the body language, again, instructive. Boxers often have a sense more than anyone else as to how the contest has gone. And a man who raised his arm immediately, while Jusupov went back to his corner in rather subdued fashion, comparatively subdued fashion, was Jusupov, whereas Vikas celebrated instantly. Well, a very good display of boxing from the two-time Olympian, now three-time Olympian, Vikas Krishant Yadav. Let's get the official verdict at the conclusion of an incredibly skillful competitive bout.
And the winner by split decision in the red corner.
And here's confirmation.
India,
Vikas Krishant Yadav through to the championship final on a split decision victory over the reigning world championship bronze medalist Ablay Khan Jusupov, the tournament number two seed, eliminated here at the final four stage. But remember, he's going through to his second consecutive